aching pain. When you're away, like a burning ship that sets the sails to you.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL.
Okay, Larry, Charles, and I, we have brought our talents to South Beach, or at least in the neighborhood of South Beach, as we are in beautiful Miami, Florida. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the New England Patriots and the Miami Dolphins. So now the Patriots getting set to take over on offense. And they'll be led out by their quarterback, the Stanford man. It's Andrew Luck.
I love everything about Andrew Luck's game, but I also love his worldliness. Some of his formative years were spent growing up outside of the United States. And I think that that's helped him when he came back because now he's seen the world. I think that helped him mature a little bit as well.
On first and 10, Luck. And his first look is incomplete. Forte, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. Partner, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine. Throwing on third down. Luck. A dump off to Forte. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, here's Pat McAfee to kick it away. Back deep, Travis Benjamin.
Obviously, they didn't get everything they wanted on that completion, but they put themselves in a spot where you've got to at least think about going for it. I know where we are on the field, but still, you've got to think about it, don't you?
Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15, and it'll be Dolphin football. The lone setback is Langford. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's across the 43, extra yards to the 43. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and six. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Second down following the run. Now Griffin on second down. He's got Wilson, middle of the field. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
They'll try to run for the first with Langford. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
I know it's the first half, but it's still hard to curb the enthusiasm for that stop. Third and one, and the offense can't get there. The defensive team has got to feel very good about themselves. Great job out-leveraging the offense.
And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys are a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went
and
three and out.
And have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. They stay on the ground. Forte again. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a third and 13. Well, that was better than the first go-around when he lost yardage, but still nothing there, and that sets up a third and long. Tough spot here.
Put it mildly, sometimes I wonder if some of that old-school football should come back into play. You know what I would think here? Quick kick. Try and change field position. Help out your team.
Throwing right, and that's complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
As far as I'm concerned, Andrew Luck can do it all. I mean, he's an underrated runner, toughness in the pocket, strong and stout. But let's face it, the money, that comes from his arm.
And smart, valedictorian of his high school class in Houston that he goes to Stanford. He's got it all. A running play now for Forte. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still, a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Now it's Luck. Over the middle and caught by the tight end play. Call it a gain of five, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
They come up in an offset eye. They'll try and get it with Forte. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. They went backwards 5 yards there on third down to break up fourth.
Obviously, the offense thought they had something going by trying to go wide on a short yardage play. But how about the defense expecting something in the middle and still able to adjust and sprint to the edge and make the play?
And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone. That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And it's caught over the middle. Wilson. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
This is Langford on first and 10. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
Now it's Langford. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Second down and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
12 yards there as they move the chains. Coach hinted to us that we may see some old power football here in this game. We got a taste of it on that first down run.
I love how he hinted it to us. And then when we were watching practice, we were watching what they call inside drill with the offensive and defensive line. And they kept putting more defenders on the other side and saying, block that. I don't care how many guys are in there. I want to run the football this week. And boy, it has paid off for them in this game.
On first down, Griffin. And the pressure getting to RG3. He's brought down for the sack. Brandon Graham in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nope.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football, but they face a second and long to start things out. The lone setback is Langford. And he'll get it up the middle. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 6 on the run. They're going to be faced now with a 3rd and 12. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
To throw is RG3. Escaping the play. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Sean Weatherspoon in there to drop him for a loss on the play. On now the Miami field goal unit. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now, there goes Green. He's at the 40. 20. 10. 5. And he will score. Touchdown, Patriots. Jason Myers now for the extra point. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. Now after the touchdown, here's Pat McAfee to kick. Carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. Now they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Well, let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Griffin now, off the bootleg. Catch made, right side by Wilson. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it. An extra corner on the field for New England here on 3rd down.
Yeah, another DB. On 3rd down, Griffin. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, 4th and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a 1/2 foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
They'll try and run with Whitlock, the fullback. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. 5 yards on the pickup, and they're able to convert here on 4th and inches. So it'll be 1st down here after the run.
Wow, that one took some guts. If this doesn't work, you're handing them incredible field position, but this head coach is undaunted, and he makes the call to go for it, and I'll be darned if they don't get the 1st down.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner, but where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play. So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And again, this time to the tailback. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Man, wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
Now Whitlock, the fullback. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Not a lot of headway on that carry, but when you're dealing with a defensive line that can cover up your center, sometimes you got to think about getting out of that play. Not going to be a lot of space when that happens.
Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. From the gun on third down, Griffin. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Back to the running game. Let the red zone. 3 yards there. Good enough to keep the drive moving.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. The lone setback is Langford. Now Griffin on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Griffin, and he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. John Simon able to get him for a loss of about 3. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
And that's caught. Did he stay in bounds, though? He did not. Ruled incomplete. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it. Now hold everything. Here, we're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. He had his lone attempt blocked earlier. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Well, their offense has struggled for sure, but they get the field goal here and at least get on the board before half.
And that's not something we should underestimate, because just getting points on the board can sometimes have a settling effect on a team, helps them start their comeback.
On the return, here comes Amir Abdullah. Let's put our attention here now on the Dolphins' defense. They're hoping to do what they did last time, force another punt. Last time it resulted in a field goal. We'll see if they can get another stop here, though.
And the best defenses are in the business of preventing points and creating points. And that's exactly what these guys did on their last possession. Why? Because they got off the field on 3 and out, turned the ball over to their offense after the punt, and let them roll downfield and put the ball through the post for a field goal.
The drive begins with a run by Forte. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. We'll come back to Miami after this. It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. On second down, here's Locke. to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get.
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And out come the Dolphins now. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted them. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
First down. He's going to rifle one deep left. And this is caught. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Jermaine Kearse, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. Well, sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This one fielded at the 5. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they worked their way back out onto the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, well, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Over the middle and caught by the tight end Clay. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. Now a first down throw. Luck. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. Give him 13 on the pickup there. And that's good for a New England first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
He's got a man complete. It's Clay. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. To the air again. Lock. Over to the right side. Caught by Moncrief. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So completion on second down. That brings up third. clock on third down. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
The Dolphins' offense now heads back on the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Jermaine Kearse with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Dolphins strike quickly here for 6 points. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, they've almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Now Abdullah, the return. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They start on the ground with Forte. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. On second down, Forte. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Off of play action, Luck. And he's got Moncrief. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now Luck. He's got time in the pocket for the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. This one taken from the 7. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Making their way back out there now, the Patriots defense. They are down on the scoreboard as we begin the second half and looking to avoid a bigger deficit.
And I can just hear the coaches now. I can hear the head coach. Guys, first 5 minutes, first series of the second half, offense or defense, you got to set the tone.
They'll try to set that tone here.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Play action. Now Griffin. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete. The tight end, Luke Wilson, was the target. Third down here. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, look, credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. They have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
The pickup of 11, and it moves the chains.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. A good first down call as the screen play gets a 9.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Play action, it's Griffin. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Fresh set of downs here.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up and making sure it was a catch.
It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down. And quickly they get to the line. Now Griffin on 2nd down. The grab made by Kearse over the middle. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down. And the numbers comparison, and something tells me he likes the numbers a little better for this week. What do you think?
No doubt about it. And, you know, we often look for the deep meaning about, okay, why did this happen last week and this one, this. Sometimes you just play better. And we're seeing that from him. Looks happy, loose, running around, and making plays.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
On 3rd down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
On 1st down, Griffin. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse. And it's 2nd down.
Sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
The lone setback is Langford. To throw is RG3. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. That one goes for 16 yards and sets him up 1st and goal.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
They'll run here with Langford. And a little bit of space there takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's 2nd and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
They'll look to run with Langford, and he is in. Touchdown, Miami. Jeremy Langford, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead.
Well, Brandon, he just followed his nose, and his nose took him to the end zone. But how about the big guys up front giving him at least a stalemate in order to find that space?
Yeah, the O-line won the battle in the trenches there, didn't it? Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
So the offense readies for a 2nd and 4. The throw on 2nd down is locked. Left side here, caught by Clay. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, You really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target.
And oh, the ball's out. Forte loses it. And the Dolphins have got it.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
A very solid gain of 27.
I know back in the good old days, just about every team was constructed to power run to the right side. We just saw a pitch to the right side that worked pretty well.
It's easier going to the right than the left?
It just used to be very simply that the right side was always the power side. I think that's just one of those old things. I'm not sure it's still the same, but on that play, it certainly felt like we were back to the future.
Yeah, and it worked. They go play action here on first down. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. John Simon, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. It'll be a gain of 15 on the play. And they're going to face a third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On third down, Jeremy Langford. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And that will push this lead up to 20 now. So a good kick that time, and that might help to get the negative thoughts out of the mind from that earlier block.
Especially since this was not a chippy, so he had to get that one out kind of low. But his line does a nice job of protecting, and he's able to convert for 3.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Here's Luck now on second down. He's got time. Over the middle and caught by the tight end Clay. They'll give him 8 on the play, and they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. And a gain there of 11 yards.
So much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
Back to the ground on first, it's Forte. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. Back now in Miami. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On second down, here's Love. To the left side and complete for Julian Edelman. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. On first down, it's Love. He's got a man complete. It's Clay. That throw good for four. It's second down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on third and 2. One receiver left, two to the right. Third and 2, Locke. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
And he's been one of their few bright spots here this afternoon.
And as you pointed out, so far he's gotten his. That's not been the issue at all. But the teammates, the other guys, they've been shut down. That's why the defensive guys have to feel pretty good, even though he's over 100 yards.
Yeah, he topped 100 with that last catch. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll bring up second down. And the seemingly endless drive continues. Throwing is Locke. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
Okay, when the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot no matter who's covering him. Doesn't matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back. He usually has the advantage because of his body type.
On the ground, Forte. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriot score. Matt Forte, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Patriots get a score closer.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The Dolphins getting set to go here. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up, because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. The lone setback is Langford. And he'll get it up the middle. And some room to work. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. So here we go, first and 10 now.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Langford, and he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about 4. David Amerson able to bring him down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Wilson snags it left side. It goes as a gain of 8 and moves the chains. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And he's going to take it down to about the 35 here. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football.
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Dante Hightower, and he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. Two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy, because with a two-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. A good start there on first down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores. They have to find a way to put it in the end zone. Chunk plays, explosive plays. That will be the key to this drive.
Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. He got 29 yards that time.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you? Every team we ever talk to that continues to run the ball in a game, even when they haven't had much success, all talks about attrition, don't they? If you keep running it, eventually good things are likely to happen. It's been a hard go in this game today, hasn't it?
Yeah, this defense, they've met pretty much every chance. And he's in! Touchdown, Patriots! Matt Forte with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Patriots have cut it back within a score. Nice execution there. Good job by the O-line getting him in for the second time.
And you always have to start with credit there when you're having a big game. I mean, you don't get there by yourself. That's rare. But how about the ability to see the proper holes, pick the proper place to go, and find his way into the end zone?
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. So now here come the Dolphins. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better. Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
On second down, Langford. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They're facing a critical 3rd down now as they try to hold on to this lead. On 3rd down, Griffin. And that is incomplete. Here's Marquette King now. On for his 2nd punt. He'd take a repeat of his 1st. He gets this one away. And boy, it's another boomer. It'll be a 48-yard punt. 5 there on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, Every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. Back to throw. Man open right side, it's the tight end Clay. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll look to throw. Over the middle and caught by the tight end Clay. And oh, he coughed it up. And fortunately, he's able to recover himself, but the clock's still rolling here. Well, they have the yards anyway, so they're going to decline the penalty. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it, that's a...
And he's in! Touchdown, Patriots! Julian Edelman, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Patriots can take the lead with the extra point.
Well, I don't want to overlook the touchdown because that was huge. That ties the game. But you know where I'm going, don't you?
Need the PAT, and then you need to stop on defense.
Yeah, in a big way. The guy kicking the ball through the post, that's where all the spotlight shifts to now.
The New England defense gearing up to take the field. And everything's going to rest on this drive. Can they keep them out of field goal range? Because a field goal would win it.
So now you're in that position of you can't just back off and give them easy throws. At the same time, you don't want to press them so hard they go over the top and beat you deep. So you're playing a tight defense with an idea that you have the lead, whatever you do. Don't let them in the field goal range and give that up.
Maybe tight, but not too tight.
Right? Exactly. Yeah, I mean, it's perfect, right? It's kind of like lacing up your shoes. Get it exactly.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. They'll come out in the pistol. He'll look to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Brandon, we did watch him play well on tape last week, and it was a lot of fun to watch, and he put together some nice numbers, some really nifty plays, and he's doing it again this week, and what I'm seeing is the rest of his team starting to rise in confidence as well.
Rubbing off a little bit?
I think so, and I think that they're buying into him. They believe it.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Brandon Graham in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. He's back to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So third and 15, and an extra defensive back in the game now.
Flooding the passing lanes.
And to the left side here, Wilson. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. And he locates Luke Wilson. It'll be a gain of 9, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They have no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times?
Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So it's up now to one of the most accurate kickers in NFL history, Justin Tucker. He did have one blocked earlier. This time it's for the win. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And you know, in an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent out there or a solid pro like this? Answer's pretty evident to me.
Now Abdullah, the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.